Hi, this is Sebastian Haas again. I know many of you have been waiting for this video for a long time, and finally here it is. I'll show you how Opvs Contra Natvram came into being, how I was involved in the process, and we'll take a deep dive into the sessions. Hope you enjoy it as much as the last video about I Loved You at Your Darkest. This video will be divided into episodes, each showing a different song or a set of songs. If you don't want to miss any of them, please subscribe to my channel and make sure you get notified whenever a new episode comes out. First of all, my involvement. I was the guitar and vocal engineer, and I also coordinated the production. All tracks from other studios were sent to me. I was the guy to put it all together and give it the first shape, do all the necessary edits and some additional production like adding extra effects. In the end, I prepared the sessions for Joe Berizzi, who had been chosen to mix the album. Drums were tracked at Tall Pine Records studio, one of the best sounding studios in Poland. Daniel Bergstrand was the producer and editor, while Haldor Grunberg was the engineer. Bass was tracked at Heinrich House Studio and engineered by Philip Heinrich Haucha. The secret ingredient in this delicious tone was definitely the addition of a guitar amp to produce a distorted, mid-oriented sound. The orchestral parts were composed and conducted by Jan Stokłosa, tracked at Sound & Wave Studio and engineered by Tomasz Butkiewicz. All synths and samples were done by Orion himself. The album was mixed by Evil Joe Berizzi at Joe's House of Compression, assisted by Jun Murakawa. I really loved Joe's work on two albums, and I was sure he would deliver something unique. For years, Joe has been one of my mixing gurus I always look up to, and this collaboration was a dream come true for me. Especially that he did use many of the pre-mixed stems and layers I prepared for him to retain some of the sound we achieved early at the production stage. Thank you, Joe! The sound of Opvs Contra Natvram is different from today's overproduced metal albums. It's very organic, naturally brutal, and mid-centered. I'd say it was pretty courageous of the band to go that route. But the final result is what an opus really deserves, a distinctive, memorable tone. And finally, the album was mastered by a mastering legend, Bob Ludwig, at Gateway Mastering Studio. Bob has mastered countless hit records and is probably the most known mastering engineer of all time. Now let's get to the guitar and vocal recording part. All of these were tracked at Sound Division Studio between January and October 2021. Nergal used his custom ESP LTD fed through a Bogner Uberschall paired with a messy cab. He also used his hollow body Gretsch in several places. Seth used his ESP LTD EX guitar through a PV5150 paired with an orange cab. For solos, Nergal used an ESP LTD Nergal 6, while Seth used some additional BC Rich vintage guitars. There was also a third amp for rhythm guitars, Marshall JCM900, set at low gain. We used it as a source of dynamic signal, mixed with mostly flat wall of distorted guitars. Mics used for cabinet capture were SM57, SM7B and R121. All rhythm guitars were quad-tracked, two takes done by Seth, panned left, and two takes by Nergal, panned right. But not all mics were used all the time. In take one, we would only use the Bogner signals, and in take two, we would only use the 5150 with the JCM. Dlaczego? That approach eliminated the buildup of unwanted frequencies. Listen how the sound changes when I mix in the low-gain JCM. everything becomes more dynamic and chuggy. The Marshall sound is far from being a hard-hitting, ball-grinding metal tone, but it adds structure and clarity to high-gain signals. Vocals were captured with a Shure SM7 and a Slate Digital ML1 combo. We chose ML1 in a blind test over other condenser mics. It worked really well with the SM7, producing little sibilance and a punchy, detailed vocal tone. There were no Slate mic emulations used, just a plain mic signal. Let's listen to this amazing Seth solo. Moving on to Nurgle's singing parts.
Am I of God or Satan, or an obsidian hemisphere? Am I the fated sovereign, or sanctitude in verse?
And now the screams, growls and whispers.
Am I to act alone? If so, I separate the meat from bone. Am I to act alone? If so.
The orchestral intro seemed a little boring to Nurgle. He asked if I could make it sound more disturbing. So I did this. Added reverb. Added compression. Then a simple distortion. And an RC20 to give it a worn cassette sound. Later, I did the same with Orion's string samples. Added distortion and RC20. Then I sidechained the compressor to duck the strings during brass hits, so the strings could come out in the pauses. And finally, I bounced one brass hit, pitched it down by an octave, reversed it, and trimmed the tail. Later in the song, the orchestra plays clean, without these effects.